In this video, I'm going to explain YouTube analytics to you in a step-by-step way so you can actually use it. YouTube analytics is a part of YouTube Studio where you can see all the data and graphs of your videos. So the amount of views, subscribers, traffic sources, and so forth. If you pay close attention to your analytics, you can grow faster or even explode the amount of views on your videos. But YouTube analytics is pretty extensive and can therefore be also a bit overwhelming. I'm gonna help you with that in this video. I'm gonna stick to the basics, the most important stats you need to know, and if you want to, you can dive into stuff yourself. I appreciate you tuning in. My name is Dexter Clark from the Netherlands, and with socialvideoplaza.com and this YouTube channel, I help entrepreneurs explode their revenue with the help of YouTube. And if you're into that sort of thing, you should consider subscribing. And while you're at it, hit the bell so you get a notification when I upload a new video. If you're not in YouTube Studio already, go to YouTube Studio. And your basic analytics you already have in your dashboard. For example, here I have the performance of my last video. It ranks the video in order from 1 to 10. And it displays you the amount of views, impressions, click-through rate, and the average view duration. And over here are your overall channel analytics. So it says your current subscribers, how much subscribers you gained over the last 28 days. And I'm here some stats, and you see my views have gone down because I had a really popular video that has gone down recently. And over here, my top three videos. I can click over here to go to channel analytics, or I can go over here to go to video analytics. There are two analytics pages, one for a specific video and one for general for the whole channel. I can click here, but I can also click on the left side of the screen. There's analytics and this item will do exactly the same. On the top of the screen, we have a couple of tabs, overview, reach, engagement, audience, and revenue. Let's go over all of them step by step. Over here, we have some abbreviations of what is going on your channel. So this is what is going on with my views. This is what is going on with my watch time. I can click on that. This is the graph that displays me the views, and this is the graph that displays me the watch time. This is the graph that displays how many subscribers I got, and over here is the graph when it comes to revenue. Under this graph, you have the releases of the videos, so you know when or which videos you released. This is 28 days, but you can set, if you want to, another period, for example, 90 days, then it will explain what has happened over the last 90 days. And you can see I released a video every week over here, and here once every 2 weeks. I can also set this to the last 365 days. And then you see my channel had a growth here and went down here. I can go to the advanced mode over here, then it will go into more detail about the statistics over here. See more will do the same. I will first discuss what this is doing here. This is your performance over the last 48 hours. So my best performing videos over the last 48 hours. And when I click here, see more, then it will display me all the videos that have the best performance over the last 48 hours. I'd like to have a little bit an eye on the videos that I have, so I know a little bit how many views, or how many views that there are on a video. So I have a little bit a understanding of what is going on. Over here you see what are the views over the last 48 hours. And here are people up and awake, and here are people sleeping, up and awake and sleeping. And we're now going to the part where people are awake, because America wakes up, and that is my main target audience for this channel. And this is the performance over the last 60 minutes, and you can see by video broken down what the performance is over the last 48 videos and the 48 hours, and what about the last 60 minutes. Click on the X to discard this window, and then we go back to the channel analytics window. On the bottom of this page, there are your top performing videos over the last period. In this period, selected over here. So I have it almost always on 28 days. Then I can see over the last 28 days, these were my top performing videos. And over here I have my latest video, the performance of my latest videos. That is somewhat the same snapshot card as that was on the dashboard. Oh, and by the way, if you like this video, you're probably gonna like what I have in store for you on this channel. Subscribe and hit the bell so you get a notification when I upload a new video. I can dive into the nitty-gritty detail over here by clicking See More. Now it will show me a graph of my last 5 videos, and this is the performance of those last 5 videos, the amount of views. I can select this item, then it will show me a total of what has happened over the last few 28 days. Again, you can change this period if you want to. Otherwise, it will color my best performing videos over here, and those are corresponding with the colors over here. I can select one video if I want to, or multiple videos if I want to, so I can compare the stats against each other. And this is a pretty extensive list of all the videos that are on the channel. What is showing, you can set here. Earlier we looked at the revenue, and now I have the views. But I can set it also to watch time or subscribers. You can select if you want a secondary metric. You can break this down entirely. You can also set the kind of chart you want. I can set it, for example, to a bar chart. But I'd like to have it on a line chart. If you want to, you can make groups of content. And you can compare groups of content. For example, what I did to see what is going on, why are my views declining, I want to know why that is. I made a group of videos. I can select the different videos here or here, or I can make a group of content. For example, I made a group for all the DAW videos, the digital audio workstations, the computers for music. But I also made a comparison for long-time videos against short-term videos. The short-term videos are the videos that are only applicable to a short amount of time, and this is part one, and this is the other part. I can select here the other part, so I can compare my short-term videos against my long-term videos. And over here you can see, well, my long-term videos are performing way better than short-term videos, but I can see that my long-term videos have gone down, but my short-term videos have not. And this can be really, really helpful information to focus on your next video project. Another important tab is the traffic source tab. That is the thing that I think we use the most. Over here you can see, hey, what about YouTube search? That's the blue line. What about the external? What about the suggested videos, browse features, etc.? And you can check that, and then it will only have one graph over here. You can even specify this even further. Again, you can do that also for another period. And I can click on YouTube search. What are the most searched topics for the videos on my channel? And then I can see, hey, best audio interface was my best search. Maybe I can do another video about that, because then it will be suggested, because it has a lot of content that is the same or in the same genre as what I had before. So that will trigger suggested, that means more views. The same thing for DAW. I know if I want to make more views, if I want to generate more views, these are the topics to expand on. Best DAW, DAW audio interface. And when I click here, I can go back to traffic source. And I can also see, hey, where is my external traffic coming from? I can guarantee you the most, Google is my most important search engine. But here you can see that my website, learnhowtoproducemusic.com, is really important for my views. And you see this has gone down also. Okay, so now I know, hey, I need to look at my website too. Let's go to traffic sources again. But I can also see, when it comes to suggested videos, which videos are suggested the most. And here I can see that my best DAW for music production that this video referred to my video and that these views have gone down drastically. So now I know, that is why my views have declined. Again, you can specify this really in great detail, geography, so the countries, United States, not really a surprise there, viewer age, viewer gender, date, revenue source. And before I continue, YouTube Studio, I know, is a pretty extensive tool. And what is your biggest takeaway from this video? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you have a question or maybe a suggestion for a video topic, also let me know in the comments below. I can make a new video about it. Again, this is your most important view because that gives you an overview of what is going on. And the same for all the other tabs. And you can break it down if you want to. Let's go to reach, because in reach, that says everything about your audience. How does my audience reach my videos? I can see over the last 28 days that, again, my views have declined, of my impressions have declined over here. What about my click-through rate? Well, my click-through rate has slightly gone up. What about the views and what about the unique viewers? Over here, I have the source, the traffic sources. YouTube search is my most important, external, my second important, suggested videos. Over here, the impressions that led to watch time. This is the watch time funnel. This is how many impressions, how many people saw my thumbnail and clicked through. Well, 5.9% clicked through and I got 106,000 views from the impressions and the amount of watch time that it led to. Over here, my external sources, Google search, learn how to produce music, YouTube, Facebook, and over here, my playlist, which were my most popular playlists, best laptop computer for music production. Probably if I make another video about computers for music production, I will put this in this playlist and it has a higher chance of getting more traction quickly. Because I know now that this playlist is popular. Over here, I have the suggested videos. Which videos suggested my videos the most? Again, you can dive deeper into this by clicking over here, then you will get that that graph again. And this is what we saw before. I click this away. And over here, what was the most searched term when it comes to my videos? Well, best audio interface. 2020. And again, I can dive into this more deeper. Let's take a look at engagement. And engagement says everything about how do people react to my videos. So my top videos, the top videos by end screen, so the last 20 seconds of my videos, what were the best performing. Over here, my top performing playlists, the end screen elements, which kind of end screen elements were the most popular. Playlist is pretty popular, but the most popular is video. The top cards, those eye icons in the top right corner of your screen. Watch time hours has gone down regretfully, and the average view duration is pretty the same. Now I'm really curious, if I take this over a lifetime, how much did my average view duration change? And you see, my average view duration has gone slightly down over the years. Bad, 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 Dexter. Okay, let's go to audience. I'm going to set this to 28 days. My unique viewers, my average views per viewer, and my subscribers are over here. When are the most popular times that people watch your videos? Well, I can see it's around 6 p.m. For me, 6 p.m. And in America, that's probably somewhere in the morning. And the subscriber notification, there's a difference between people that enabled all the notifications and the people that enabled all the notifications but didn't get it. For example, I have disabled all the notifications on my phone. So that means that the amount of viewers that have enabled all the notifications on all their devices is lower than the amount of people that have enabled all the notifications. The top countries, again, you can dive deeper if you want to. Watch time from subscribers. This is to get a quick overview so you don't have to look at all the boring graphs. This breaks down for you what is the most important. So I can see, for example, my most popular audience is between 25 and 34 years old. And these are the most subtitle, the most important subtitle languages. And here is broken down my revenue. The statistics of how much I earned my estimated revenue, the monetized playbacks, how much, if you have, for example, a ad blocker enabled, that means that I don't get ad money. And what is my CPM? So how much did I earn per 1,000 ads? Over here, my estimated revenue of June, May, April, March. My top earning videos with the broken down with revenue. The ad types, skippable ads has earned me the most revenue sources. Now we have looked at the analytics of the channel as a whole, but you can break it down even further by video level if you want. So let's go to videos. And when you hover over an item, you can go directly to analytics here. And now you will see on the top of the page, we have the same tabs as we had on the channel level: overview, reach, engagement, audience, revenue. But there are some extra options over here. You can see, by the way, here the real-time activity of the video, which drove the most views, YouTube search, suggested a little bit. Over here we have the audience retention, and when it comes to graphs or analytics, this is the most important graph to look at, because here you can see what is happening with your video. When I click on see more, then on the top of the screen there is a video player, and when I play this, you can see that there is a line over here and that points to where we are in the video. Here we can see how viewers react to my video. So I can see there is a point here that viewers are, that is number one. Here's a point in the video, here is a point in the video, here is a point in the video, and here is a point in the video. And at the end of the video is something going on, and that is the end screen, and people are clicking away because the video is over. You need to make this as short as possible. You want to have this at 50%. 40% is pretty good. If you have 50, 60, then you will go through the roof on YouTube. But I'm not unhappy with the performance of this video. Average view duration, 40%. What happens here? That is what I like to know. I know there are timestamps in the video, and I know that people skip to the next parts of the video. So I know that these drop-off points in this video doesn't mean anything special. But for example, if you have your intro over here, your bumper over here, and you see that there is a massive drop off, then you need to make sure that you get rid of the bumper or do something with that bumper. It gives you really keen insights on what viewers are liking or don't like about your video and are clicking away to other videos. The rest in this screen is pretty much the same as when it comes to the view of the whole channel. If you like these kinds of videos, you should definitely check out my playlist right here with more YouTube beginner tutorials. If you just started or thinking about starting a YouTube channel, you should definitely check out my ultimate beginner's guide on starting a YouTube channel right here. Don't forget to subscribe if you like to see more.